Name that movie. Betty. Betty. Oh, Betty. You took my cat.
What's that story? The new one. I don't know.
So I married an axe murderer.
No, cool. I've never seen him. Juice!
Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Direct Eats.
It is Korbin.
I'm Rick.
What are you eating?
Your mom?
No, it's not.
Fish taco from Del Taco.
I thought I smelled your mother.
Fishy. Okay, here we go. Today...
I'll tell her she needs to bathe.
Today we got an old trailer, so it's probably not
going to
be a very good trailer, but it's supposed to be a really good film.
Fan-made or like the legit trailer from
it's
back?
It's probably a fan-made, I'd imagine.
Oh, I wanted to hear...
there's no like actual...
In a time that land forgot.
No, but it's no, there's no like official, because it came out in, I believe, 1987 around then?
There were trailers back then.
Okay, shut up. But this is called Mirch Masala.
Mm.
This is by, say this name? Kitan Mehta. Mirch Masala is a stunning depiction set in a village in colonial India.
Mm.
A tyrannical...
So what is it?
Subhidar? Nisardan Shah.
Oh man.
Desires a married Sunbai by Smita Patil,
mm-hmm.
who refuses his advances blatantly. He threatens to destroy the village. Sita doesn't submit to his demands, set in rustic India.
Indrani, what is, if someone were a tyrannical Subhidar? Subhidar. S-U-B-H-E-D-A-R. Landowner?
No idea.
Okay.
Anyways, but Nisardan Shah, and it has this actress, what's her name?
Smita Patil.
Who a lot of people, is like their favorite actress. She's like supposed to be like one of the best actresses in terms of like
thespian. Got it.
And this was from a time, I think it was supposed to be in the 80s. It's called parallel cinema. I don't know. Don't ask me why they call it that. Well, they, I do know why, but it
right.
just doesn't make sense to me. Because that sounds like multiverse, right? It sounds
yeah.
like that.
No, and I remember the term. I just don't remember
why it
was called
that. It's basically
called
an art house film. It's parallel to commercial cinema.
Right.
So that's why they call it that. So Nisardan Shah, Om Puri, She,
Alternate.
A lot of, they were like, that was their genre.
Got it.
The parallel cinema. And this is supposed to be one. It's supposed to be a fantastic film. So the trailer's like, it's not, it doesn't, actually
do
show
justice.
How good the film is. So just be aware. But they wanted us to do so. If there's like parallel cinema and of her as well, she's an actress we have not explored yet. We've seen her in a song with Amitabh Bachchan.
Okay.
But that's it.
Speaking of thespians, no joke, Nick Cage in an interview recently said he doesn't like the term actor. He would be preferred. He would prefer it if people called him a thespian, not an actor.
Well, that depends on his film. Sometimes he is not a thespian.
I'm just telling you what he said.
Sometimes
just
he
tell
can
you what
be.
He said.
Not always, though.
Have you seen Pig?
No, I haven't.
Yeah,
I'm interested
to
watch it.
I've seen it, but I'm going to say nothing. I want you to see
interesting.
It, and then see what you think of it. I have definite opinion about it, obviously, but it's a pig.
Here we go. Nice.
सुबेदार कहता है कि सोनबाई उसकी गुनहगार है और हमें उसे सुबेदार को सौंप देना चाहिए
जाओ कह दो सुबेदार से कि गांव में एक तो मर्द मौजूद है
मैं जान दे दूंगी लेकिन उसके पास नहीं जाऊंगी
आज उसने सोनबाई मांगी कल वो आपकी बीवी मांगेगा और परसों किसी की बहन सारे गांव की इज्जत का सवाल है मजा तो तब है कि सांप भी ना मरे लाठी भी ना टूटे और काम बन जाए
could definitely obviously tell it was just a cut trailer.
But I gotta say, it was better than I was expecting.
Yeah, and you could tell, and obviously the quality was less because of...
Of course.
They basically filmed it probably on what they were doing.
Yeah.
You could tell the performances are there, though.
You absolutely can.
From she looks her, she real looks strong, and then
really good.
You're not gonna get a bad performance from
that. Yeah, then start a job.
Yeah, you're not gonna get a bad performance from that man.
But she was immediately captivating.
I wonder if that word means a Indian who's basically a British Army person.
Ah, could be.
Because obviously. He's Indian, but he looked like he was
dressed in British clothing.
British clothing.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering if it means like
a British, an Indian who's serving the British military.
Maybe
thinking about the Akshay film?
No. I'm thinking it's something completely different. You know, in like Django, when.
Oh, yes.
What's his name?
Samuel L. Jackson.
Samuel Jackson was called the House N-word, right?
Yep.
And so, like, he's basically working with the white people.
Right, he's got the rights and the privileges to work alongside the whites.
I'm wondering if that's similar, like, he's like an Indian
I bet that
who
is.
Sold out his country.
Wouldn't surprise
to
me.
To work for the Indians.
Yeah,
I mean, work for the British. But yeah, obviously, he looked really, I loved his stash. And nice, wonderful stash.
Did too.
But she looked incredibly strong.
Immediately.
And that's from the terrible quality of
the trailer. That's why I was so impressed. I was impressed by two things. I could tell, because you can tell, even if it's a herky-jerky kind of a trailer, you can tell the intention behind this was to make something of a substantive film, a work of art, which doesn't surprise me because everything we know about that man, it's all about art form for him. Would love, obviously, to talk to him.
I would watch this right now.
Absolutely. Does it qualify?
Unfortunately, it's 1986.
Well, it's only a...
6 years. 6 years.
It's still a class. I still say if it's over a quarter century old, it should qualify. That's what I say.
You guys can let us know if you think it would classify. Have you ever seen anything of hers? Yeah, she's good.
She's like, yes. Legend.
Yeah. Have we seen Katin Mehta? I'm trying to...
No. Can't. Sardar.
What do you mean?
His name was under... You went over that and Sardar popped up for
You're
him.
You're thinking of Sardar Udham.
No, I'm thinking of
we
that
haven't
film.
Seen it.
No, but we know that film.
No, I don't think so.
Sure.
Sardar, I've never heard of Sardar.
What?
It's Tom Alter. We've never seen anything with Tom Alter.
No, I know we haven't seen it, but I could have sworn I have seen that.
No. You've seen Sardar Udham.
Well, I know that.
But this guy is actually, it's funny, Tom Alter, he's the white guy.
Right.
He always played the angry Britisher.
Right.
So he was like the most famous white actor. But we've never actually seen anything of him. Surprised we haven't.
I know, at this point.
I thought we would have seen him in like a supporting role, just he'd be in
somewhere.
You guys can let us know a first film.
We need to come up with that for the dummies. I just thought of it.
Best white actor?
Best white actor.
Oh, it'll definitely been Sardar Udham.
Well, yeah, and some years we won't have one.
There would have been like two entries. Like them and then the people in Mimi who did okay.
But it's worth elevating and letting people know they're out there if we can find them.
Yeah, so her, I know some certain people have been really screaming at us to get into parallel cinema. And also, she died real young.
Well,
look at this.
Oh,
look at this.
Crap. Yeah.
55 to 86?
31 years old. That's terrible.
Yikes. That's like Keith Ledger kind of.
Yeah,
Heath
that's
Ledger
awful.
Died when he was 28.
That's awful.
Yeah, so.
1955. She should still be here.
Yeah, this reminded me of also like Parched and Hell Aroused.
Exactly.
Like that, the red tones.
And anybody who knows us would, if parallel cinema is basically the art house cinema of the day, of course that's going
to
be
interesting
right
to us.
Oh, yeah.
It just makes no. I understand it, like, parallel to commercials. Like, I feel like art house would probably work better.
It would, but it makes sense in terms of Indian cinema's history.
Mm-hmm.
If it's not, you know, because everything was designed for box office, the public. That is our determining factor. Is it going to be absorbed and loved by the masses? And then if you're going to do something that's not that, and you're going to risk it for the sake of art, it's that other place.
Yeah.
Back then.
I would very much like to get into some of her work. Obviously, Nasser. We'll see anything that man's ever done.
Anything he's ever done.
He's so good. Yeah, he looks
really... Pori's in this.
Oh, is he? I didn't see him in there.
Maybe he was the guy with all the makeup on who said there's another man in this village.
Oh.
Maybe that was Om Puri. And we just didn't recognize him because of the wig and makeup.
Heavily bearded. Maybe, yeah. I know, like, when I've been told about parallel cinema, those three names come up a lot.
Yeah.
Like, that, they love, like, because it's all story-driven and acting-driven.
Bring it on.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Right? Bring it on.
If this is a film that we should start with, if I can get a hold of it, I don't know if I can.
That's going to be the challenge.
If I can. And also, obviously, any other month I could have gotten to this right away, but... it's classic month, and this technically does not qualify for a classic month. It said 1986. So if there's another film of hers that also classifies, or if you're like, forget it, just do it. Or we can get to it in, I don't think it'll qualify for romance month. Probably.
It doesn't look like it.
A weird romance.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it.
A guy trying to rape a woman, I guess.
Wow.
Anyways, let us know what the first film of Smita Patil.
Smita Patil.
Yeah, it should be. Down. Do you remember the first film of Nir Sen and Shah that we saw?
Yes, I sure do. Deborah.
No.
Yeah.
Wait. No.
Yes. Yes. No. That's where we were first introduced to him.
No.
And said, that guy's a thespian.
Mm-hmm. League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
I've never seen the League of Extraordinary
Gentlemen. I have.
I saw it when I was a child.